Education. The teaching landscape has fundamentally changed during the pandemic, from teacher shortages to remote learning. An industry expert is here to tell us what the landscape looks like for America's teachers. Joining us now is Lynette Guastaferro. She is the CEO of Teaching Matters. She's joining us now. Thanks so much for coming on.
Thank you for having me, Andy. Appreciate it.
Pandemic has made the teaching landscape very complicated. What are you seeing?
Well, teachers, everyone's going back to school, and I think we all know the kids are happy to be there. I think the teachers have a real set of challenges ahead of them, and they're generally exhausted. If you look at a RAND survey recently, it showed that stress is the really number one reason why teachers are leaving the profession. Teachers are describing themselves as May tired, not October tired. You might need to be a teacher to know what that means, but and teachers are returning where we've had, 3 million students that actually disappeared during the course of the pandemic. And we know that students where there were kids of color had much less access actually to school in many cases. So what you're seeing is kids are returning with unfinished learning. And teachers have kids at all different levels in their classroom.
What about the response to mask mandates? People have incredibly strong opinions there.
So in New York, I'm coming from New York, and there's controversy, but a little bit less controversy here than I know there have been in some other communities. Largely what I've seen in New York is really where schools just really have to enforce the policies that kids wear the masks, just kind of like you have to enforce any policy. And there's some schools that are doing that really well, and there's other schools that are taking it a little bit, they're not as effective at it. And so that's more the kind of level of problem we have in New York. You know, in other places, we don't have the kinds of uprisings that I've seen in some other states, not to the same degree.
Let's talk about shortages. What are we seeing, and how can that be rectified?
So what we know are that there's the shortages that may exist now, which I think the most recent. So, for example, there were 9,000 seats, classroom seats, staff shortages in August in Florida, reported by the Education Association. California, South Dakota have also reported significant teacher shortages. I think the more concerning number is when teachers are surveyed, many of them are thinking about that the pandemic has increased their likelihood for early retirement. And so I think that it's not only the case of shortages now, but the question is moving forward, will we see greater shortages over time as teachers are, some of them are really looking to exit the profession. Again, teachers have not recovered from the pandemic and they're going back in. And I think that's true. I mean, this is true across the workforce, correct? You know, we know that people are leaving their jobs in many, many professions, and I think education is no different.
Well, where do we go from here?
Well, number one, I think it's, for me, it's like we need to get back in. It's everybody who is, so, you know, in my organization, we're all returning to the office. The classrooms are back in. I think that we start with the joy that we see in the kids, because the one group that is better than ever, I think, are the children. They are so happy to be back. Anyone that has a child, I think you've seen the difference in your own child's kind of attitude in the last, having returned. I see it in my own son. And that's what teachers speak to. When you ask teachers to figure out, like, where's your source of joy right now? It is definitely how glad the kids are to be back. And that's giving teachers a lot of hope or a lot of good vibes.
Okay, Lynette Guastaferro, thanks so much for coming on.
Appreciate it. Thanks, Andy.